tonight, taking on Western Carolina, Southern Conference rivalry renewed, and the second meeting between these two schools here in this regular season. Along with Daryl Koziak, I'm Scott Przewanski. Appreciate you being with us. And Daryl, we look at UNCG, third game of a three-game homestand. They started off knocking off the Citadel by 20. They knocked off Samford by 28. Seems like the Spartans are starting to get in a groove here in February.
They are, and Coach Miller definitely has their attention. Now, Citadel, yes, they won by 20. They didn't play very well. So there was a purpose and a focus on the UNCG team last Sunday that we hadn't seen in a little bit. So I'm interested to see if that carries over, not only to this game, but the rest of the season. If it is, Southern Conference, look out.
Well, for Western Carolina, much improved team from last year, and a guy in Mason Faulkner, if you haven't seen him play, keep your eyes open here tonight.
Yeah, he's transferred from Northern Kentucky. He's really made a huge difference on this team. A couple different ways. You can see second in assists in the Southern Conference. Western wants to get out and run fast, and because of Faulkner looking ahead, they can do that with a high rate of success. And in the half court, breaking you down one-on-one and then making plays for others, but he's not just a table setter. You can see here, he's also the second leading scorer in the Southern Conference, has attempted 150 threes on the year as well. So if you're going to play off him, he's going to step up and knock it down. Whatever the team needs, Mason Faulkner is going to deliver.
Yeah, the Spartans did a good job on him up in Callaway. He only scored 5 points in that game. We'll see if it switches for the Spartans. Boy, Callaway has been on fire here at home.
Yeah, last four games, averaging 45% from three, really starting to get really back from his injury that was at the beginning of the conference play. But just when you think he's just all offense, he's had 9 block shots over the last 4 games, playing both sides of the floor, anchoring the UNCG team.
The senior from Milton, Georgia, and Kyren Galloway, he had 19 points a season high in the last outing. But I want to go back to that last thing you touched about. He is another rim protector for UNCG on the defensive end. And if it wasn't for James Dickey, you know, with his 44 blocks, you know, Galloway with 35, that's who you'd be talking about, you know, the defensive end.
They're 1-2 in the Southern Conference. They got a little competition going between them, especially in the last couple of games. Galloway's been able to get his blocks because teams were driving to the paint. They're so concerned about Dickey, they forget about Galloway coming from the weak side. So it's a great 1-2 punch around the paint.
First game up in Cullowhee, UNCG trailed at the half by 1, and it was a tight game up until about the 7-8 minute mark before the Spartans ended up pulling away. They won that game 72-58. Isaiah Miller had 23 points. Galloway, who we mentioned, had 15 to lead the way for UNCG, and they forced Western Carolina into 17 turnovers. The Catamounts want to play with pace here today. Spartans do also, but maybe more so they want to play with pace and take the shots they want to out of that pace.
Yeah, in reading the scouting report and kind of seeing what UNCG is looking at tonight, they're going to continue to play sort of free-flowing. They know they're going to be able to get the three-pointers they want. With the style of defense that Western Carolina plays, every time a ball is put on the floor, there's going to be 2, 3, maybe 4 defenders collapsing on the drive. So the Spartans have to drive to draw that help side defense, make one kick, drive again, make a second kick, look for the extra pass. They're going to have that kind of continuity offensively. They're not going to be able to make one pass drive to the basket or one pass shoot.
Mark Prosser is the head coach for Western Carolina in his second season. And, of course, has some experience in the Southern Conference and, again, has his Catamounts 7-5 in league action and 15-8 overall. It will be Tyler Harris, the 6'7 freshman from Charlotte, jumping center against Kyren Galloway. And the Spartans going with the gold uniforms. We'll have it here to start things off again. So happy to have you with us here on tonight's broadcast from the Greensboro Coliseum. Miller, Massey, Galloway, Dickey, and Hunter, the 5 on the floor, and a steady 5 they have been as Hunter converts there early.
You see the Spartan action looked like it was going one way. Quick reversal after a couple of passes. Quick move to the basket. That's the kind of sprint, that action we're going to need in the half court.
Western Carolina goes over the top of the press. The open 3 missed by Steger. Western will shoot a lot of threes. There's no question about that. Galloway will as well, and this triple is off the mark. Dickey on the offensive glass, but controlled by the Catamounts as they come into the front court. There's that long pitch ahead again. This time, Catamounts will swing it around. Carlos Dotson, maybe an underrated big man here in the Southern Conference, averages 14 points and a travel there by Steger. Dotson, 14 points, almost 10 rebounds a game, which is tops in the SoCon. And he has been a load for UNCG throughout his career.
He absolutely has been. It's hard to guard 280 pounds. That's hard. I don't care who you are.
Massey with it now over to Isaiah Miller. He'll penetrate down the lane. Floater is up and good for Isaiah Miller.
He came off that ball screen really, really tight. The way that Western Carolina wants to attack ball screens, you're going to have to curl tight and go strong to the basket.
Harris thought about the three. Instead, they'll reverse it out. Now here's Dotson going to work on the inside. Looped that one up too high off the backboard. Aaron missed. Spartans surveying as Hunter now backs it out.
Dotson got good deep position, but all the Spartan big guys want to do tonight is stay between him and the backboard, make him shoot over. It's exactly what happened in that possession.
Galloway has time to set his feet, but that three is short, so he's missed his first two. But you can't ask for a better look if you're UNCG. Drive by Harris, scooped it up, no good. Dotson on the offensive glass and muscles it in for two for the big man.
Deep position, that's confusion on the drive that time. Allowed deep post penetration for Western Carolina.
Massey's three away and good.
There we go. I like it when he hits him early. Really expands things offensively for the Spartans. If Massey can start knocking them down.
Shoots right around 29% from three, but is capable. And you see it there. Dotson again pounding his way on the inside. And did he travel or an offensive foul underneath?
Looked like
he dipped his shoulder.
Yep.
And that'll be the first of the game on Dotson.
Hey, Galloway was there. You can see what Western's trying to do against the press. Skip it to the deep corner to a shooter. Steger, he had 7 threes last game. So the Spartans respecting that, going to chase him off the three-point line. But as soon as it goes opposite corner, they're dumping it inside to Dotson. That's something that Western Carolina did with a high rate of success for the first half up there in Culloway.
Well, they're the leading three-point shooting team percentage-wise in the Southern Conference at 37%. They average 10 makes per game. Nice feed, and again, Hunter with an easy one.
You see what happened that time, though. Dickey puts the ball on the floor. The weak side looks at him, loses Galloway in the transition, so it's a nice feed from Dickey.
Faulkner in some trouble, and Western just does get it across the timeline. The coaching staff, UNCG, complaining they didn't think he did.
It was close.
Steger. We'll back it out. Shot clock winding down. Western trailing here by 7 and a foul with 5 on the shot clock on the pressure defense by Malik Massey.
Western UNCG pressure defense kind of taking Western out of what they want to do offensively so far. Not really feeling comfortable in the half court. Not able to get their ball screen action going.
Early substitution for Western Carolina as Halverson will check out. Travion McCray is in. Steger's got some space underneath. Might have had it partially blocked by Dickey. Dotson gets it right back. When he's that close, he's going to finish.
Yeah, it's hard. He's hard. One of the keys for UNCG is really trying to get him in action defensively, run him up and down the floor on both sides, try to wear him out by the end of the game.
Looking for another cut by Hunter, and the pass too strong by Isaiah Miller, and the turnover gives it back to Western Carolina.
Well, it was open there. You can see again, curl action to the basket. It's a little too hot of a pass from Isaiah.
Isaiah Miller will head to the Spartan sideline as the freshman Keyshawn Langley comes in. Also on the court, Angelo Allegri. You know, they say this time of year there are no more freshmen. Keyshawn Langley for the Spartans wearing number 0. He's been solid all year long.
I don't know if he's been a freshman since he's been here.
Here's Faulkner dancing with it. Allegri with a poke away. They'll play on. And Dotson again squaring up on Dickey. Dust does turn the corner. His reverse is no good. Spartans will run.
Yeah, see Dickey with a great job of keeping him off the lane that time.
Allegri quickly off the bench. Ooh. Fires a three.
Ooh. He's been really streaky shooting it the past 4 or 5 games. If he hits one, he's liable to hit 3 or 4 in a row.
Really found his rhythm at the end of the Last ball game against Samford, Steger wide open and answers.
Yeah, the breakdown there, can't leave, cannot leave him wide open.
His 56th made three of the season, shoots 43% from beyond the arc, got to know where he is. And with this dead ball, we'll have our first media timeout, 15:28 to go. Back with more here from Greensboro.
Find your way here, to a vibrant campus in the heart of a thriving city, where teaching and research inspire discovery and ignite change. Find your why, your voice, your place among students from all walks of life. Find your connection, your community, your legacy in a proud family of Spartans. Find your purpose, your journey, your home. UNC Greensboro, find your way here.
The madness of March begins in Asheville, North Carolina. Be at the Harris Cherokee Center Asheville March 5th through 9th for the 2020 Ingalls SoCon Basketball Championship presented by General Shale. You don't want to miss the action on the court as all 18 SoCon men's and women's teams compete for a conference championship and a berth in the NCAA tournament. Book your travel and tickets by logging on to SoConHoops.com or by contacting the Harris Cherokee Center Asheville box office. The madness begins here. Get your tickets today.
And everyone kind of raises an eyebrow and looks at what lies ahead down the road in February. And as you check out the Southern Conference standings, East Tennessee State and Furman tied for first place right now. Spartans still have Furman on the schedule here in Greensboro and Wofford as well, but just a log jam. Look at, you know, one game separates first and second and fourth, and fourth and fifth. And it's been some good basketball this year.
Yeah, Spartans get this one tonight. I think we may be the only conference in the country that has three teams with 20 wins.
It has been a solid, solid year in the SoCon. Dickey will hand it back to Hunter. Picks up his dribble. UNCG will run the offense through James Dickey sometimes since he's a very capable passer. Hunter settles for the three, though.
Hunter dump it back to him. He was wide open looking for it.
Faulkner spinning, can't get by Langley, just continued to pound his way in, determined to get a shot up, and last touch by Faulkner and out of bounds.
And Langley doing a good job of playing defense with hands up, moving his feet. It looks like it's Spartan basketball.
Five on the floor in gold for UNCG. Mo Abdul-Salam, along with Michael Hewitt Jr., who just came in, Keyshawn Langley, Isaiah Miller, and Angelo Allegri as they come here on the offensive end, leading 12-7 as Miller with a head of steam, and now we'll back it out. Freshman McCray on Miller. Langley's going to drive in, scoops it in for two.
Just a quick first step, rocked the defense to the right, couldn't jump to the left. It's a quick move from the young freshman.
Lead is at seven here early in the first half for the Spartans. McCray with some indecision and just did get it away. And Faulkner again going to drive it, and this time gets a little bump by Hewitt as he picks up his first. Halverson out for Western Carolina. Douglas Elks, redshirt sophomore from Raleigh, subs in for the first time.
Western had recently been kind of trimming down their bench a little bit, but they're going a little deeper tonight, trying to keep up with the depth of the Spartans.
Steger going to drive it on Allegri, picks up his dribble, kicks it out. Faulkner, long range three is off the mark. And the rebound pulled away by Xavier Court. Another possession for the Catamounts. They'll flip it back to Elks, and the Spartans will run off the miss. Miller a little out of control, finds Hewitt. And the Spartans will back it out. Or will they? Allegre with a way deep three. Ball kicked all the way to the backcourt. Hewitt's got it. They'll reset the shot clock. Miller is going to try a deep one. That's no good.
A couple more passes that time. Put the ball on the floor, then kick it out for a three.
Faulkner again pounding his way into the paint. Forces up another one, and Langley with some great defense here to start off against Faulkner. Allegri sets himself, fires again, no good.
Isaiah's got to be careful about jumping over the back. That's not the kind of cheap foul he needs to pick up.
UNCG content to shoot threes. They're now 2 of 8 from beyond the arc.
Attempted 39 threes, I believe, at Western last game.
There's Langley being a little too aggressive, whistled for the bump. And Western Carolina, I think, as you mentioned, trying to, wants their player, you know, Coach Prosser wants his guys to be fresh as long as they can moving into the second half. That was an issue in the first game at Cullowhee, and he continues to shuffle three guys in at a time as Dotson and Harris return here, as does Halverson. This is Tyler Harris. Hands it off and nearly stolen away by Isaiah Miller, and a foul on Western Carolina preventing Isaiah to go the distance. Maybe not a bad foul by Tyler Harris.
I'll tell you, so far tonight, Kyron Galloway's on-the-ball defense has been superb. Whether he's on the driver like Harris or on the big man inside or Steger challenging for threes, he's been all over the place and has done a great job of being aggressive without fouling.
Hewitt steps back, cranks a long three, and that's good.
You're playing him for the drive for some reason. You got to chase Hewitt over the top of that handoff.
Spartan
can put the ball on the floor.
Spartan lead is 10. And a steal by Galloway, just threw it right to him. Langley back to Miller. Spartans will reverse it around. Miller working on Halverson, rises, fires, and airmailed it off the right side. Western hasn't scored in the last 3.5 minutes in search of a basket here. See if they go inside to Dotson, who was so effective earlier.
They're trying to get him involved.
McCray looking inside, has to pitch it out. And now with 5 on the clock, Western in trouble. McCray drives it in, drops it off to Dotson. Had it blocked from behind. Misses the second one. The Spartans.
Good defense. How about that?
Swarming at the rim.
I like how they're doing, being aggressive without fouling for the most part.
Galloway will turn. Misses it. Rebound, Abdul Salam.
Good pass, Kyron. Western really struggled with the full court pressure.
You must owe Kyron something, to, you know, there. And as you mentioned, they are struggling with the press.
They are struggling.
Another turnover by the Catamounts. That is their 4th here already in the first half. You opened up a 12-point lead.
See here, really attacking inside out. Galloway rolling to the basket. Making a play, but definitely a pass.
Cause I need it fast, and I need it today.
When all you can burgers is think about, Post made it. For $100 in delivery credit, enter promo code EAT2020.
At Farmers, we know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two. Even bear and tear.
We are Farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
Get a quote today.
Look at the new sled on you.
Yeah, I like it. I mean,
what did you pay?
7 pelts.
So high.
Should have used Auto Trader. It's the only one with Kelley Blue Book. What
Just a few ticks left on the clock. Lillard checking the inbox.
He's got to open up a new draft.
Got to be careful with typos and punctuation here. There's no time to edit and resend.
And send.
Another gorgeous buzzer-beating email.
Just remarkable.
Percent here to start off this game. Western Carolina just 3 of 14, right around 21%. As the Spartans defense, you know, what's that press do? Even if you don't turn it over, what does it do to the offense on the other end for Western Carolina? Even if they don't turn it over, it seems like they're just out of sorts trying to start their offense.
Right, well, they start their offense higher. They start their offense with less time on the clock, so their cuts aren't nearly as aggressive. Great screen.
Isaiah Miller pulls up at free throw line, extended jump shot.
Yeah, you know, in the half court, the Spartans off every screen are coming off with a sense of purpose, like they know exactly where they want to go and what to do. They're not just wondering, they're not thinking about it. They are coming off screens with a purpose.
It's a 9-0 run for the Spartans. Again, another possession for Western that they've got to get into late. They do get a switch there, but look at the convergence. Three yellow jerseys all around Dotson underneath.
Yeah, Massey's going to be careful. I think he kind of hurt himself getting over to Dotson, but you put two hands on the defender like that. Sometimes they get called, but I think that's a half a block each for Moe and for Galloway.
3 seconds on the shot clock as Faulkner will inbound it. Steger just kind of had a little open space. The Spartans lost him and dodged one there. Great find by Faulkner. Just rifled it right through the middle of the defense.
Good. Great vision.
Oh, a little step back by Hewitt.
Little ankle breaker. That'll be on his highlight film.
12-0 run now for UNCG, 24-7, the Spartans. 4 of 10 from three, but this defensive side of the ball has been the difference, and Dotson this time able to draw a foul and will earn a trip to the line.
Really collapsing. Faulkner is having to work so hard to get the ball, whether it's Isaiah or
Langley,
Keyshawn, even Hewitt, Massey. Those guys are really dead set on making it tough for the Catamount guard.
Foul went on Mo Abdul-Salam. Dotson at 55% on the year from the line. Hewitt and Abdul-Salam will check out, and you'll bring in James Dickey and Caleb Hunter. Dotson on the year, 14 points, just about 10 rebounds a game for the senior from Riverdale, Maryland. That one free throw ends the drought. Scoreless over about 4 minutes, 45 seconds. Galloway with a touch inside for James Dickey. Turns, fires, jump hook is good.
Nice and quick. Spartans were so spread out that time, so high that Dickey was one-on-one inside. The Western Carolina help couldn't get there. Deflection, Isaiah.
Miller nearly.
2-1.
And there's the 10-second violation. And nothing makes the UNCG coaching staff more excited than getting those turnovers with their press.
Isaiah is just, I think I say this every broadcast. It's one thing to practice against this kind of pressure and the front man like Isaiah. It's another thing to see it live and in person, because you just don't, you can't anticipate the athleticism, the timing, the second bounce that he has on those plays.
Dickey again directing traffic, sees the double team coming, hands it to Hunter. He'll scoop right down the lane and just missed the little bunny.
He had it. He could have either taken the layup or Dickey was wide open on the dish.
Faulkner calling his own number, forced that one up. And the rebound down to Isaiah Miller. His head up across the timeline, feeds Hunter. This time he can't finish again. Caleb, usually a strong finisher at the rim, has missed two here.
I think he was caught between dunking it and laying it off.
I think you're right.
Get in between.
Just like the time before. And James Dickey a little too aggressive. Got away with the first reach, but then just kept after it. the Spartans will pick up their fifth team foul.
Yeah, he tried to avoid the pylon play, but you see here, Dick, you hand, nice hands off, except for that one on his left. Gets to the floor, but he kind of gets after the legs a little bit. Referee's going to call that every time. That's an every time call.
Isaiah Miller, Kyren Galloway check out. Bas Leida, freshman from the Netherlands, on the floor for the first time. Here's Steger. Look at Massey just hawking Faulkner to finally breaks free, but it can't finish that one at the rim. They are making life really difficult for Faulkner. Second leading scorer in the SoCon at just a bit better than 18 a game. Has not scored here and is 0 of 5 from the floor.
Nice screen. Oh! Dunked so hard our camera went out. Nice little secondary option there. Guard big screen. That's hard action to guard.
And the lead is now 20. Dotson trying to clear out, get some space, just using that off arm, and now brings it back in the lane, and
good
a pretty
play.
Pass
good
by the big
play.
Man.
Good play. Coach Miller saw something he didn't like. Getting right over Lights on the rotation. Quick to jump on the freshman, make a teaching point.
But James Dickey directing traffic. Fakes the pass, flushes it home. UNCG rolling here in the first half.
To knock in the first place? Well, you have to get noticed, and no one gets you noticed better than Matthews Mobile Media. Graphic advertising works, and Matthews Mobile has in-house graphic design and a production and installation team that can customize any vehicle or building advertising to support your growing business. Call Matthews Mobile Media today for a free estimate and get noticed.
Who's there?
Opportunity.
Thanks, Matthews Mobile Media.
Since 1917, Nieces has been hand-delivering our sausage fresh from our family to yours. For 100 years, we've used only the highest quality ingredients in the same family recipe that's been passed down for generations. Though the times will always change, you can be sure that one thing will stay the same. Nieces will be fresh, never frozen. Nieces, fresh has always been better.
UNCG's lead here at 18, and Western Carolina just 4 of 19 from the floor, and they have 5 turnovers, so it's never a good thing when you have more turnovers than you have made field goals. And on the other side, Spartans shooting just about 55%. So what was that timeout all about?
Well, I think that was a way to get their attention. Coach Miller saw something that broke down, but he also wants to make sure that this team keeps up their focus, because it's really easy to exhale when you're up 20 in the first half. That was we're going to make sure our focus stays at the same level for the rest of this half timeout.
Massey off a screen, misses the three. Hunter on the offensive glass, and the foul will go on Caleb Hunter. That's his first. And the sixth team foul on UNCG. You know, when you play this aggressive style or defense, you're prone to get whistles, and there's one, which is one you don't want to have if you're Massey's. He picks up two, and now you roll down to the other end, and it's 1-1 for Western Carolina. So you put the other team on the line, which has struggled to get it anything going offensively, and you give them opportunities at the line. But I think if you're Wes Miller and staff, that's what you live with. with the way they play and the style they play defensively.
Right, it is, and that's what makes us really tough to officiate sometimes, because we are aggressive and want to be aggressive and be disciplined. Sometimes guys can get carried away just a little bit, so it's hard to know where the line is. I think Massey, just trying to make sure that he's being the proper kind of aggressive, just got a little too far.
One of two at the line for Faulkner, but gets his first point. Does see the ball go through the hoop. We'll see if that helps him out a little bit more here on the offensive end. UNCG now in their set. Dickey back to Langley, fires it off the screen. Hunter with the rebound, and this time the foul will go on Western Carolina underneath, and Travion McCray, freshman from Timmonsville, South Carolina, picks up the whistle.
Caleb's been around the ball a lot tonight, struggled so far, and nice to see something go his way.
Just under 7 minutes to play, first half. UNCG looking for the season sweep here of Western Carolina, and Langley was really patient along the baseline and ends up calling the timeout. And the Spartans will huddle up here with 6:56 to go.
Yeah, I think that was the case of the screens not being too crisp that time. Didn't make contact body to body. Cutters didn't come off tight, didn't leave any options. Usually there's a deep outlet. Didn't happen that time, so Coach Miller drawing it back up, drawing something else up on the board. Wouldn't be surprised if he throws this one right to the rim.
Well, this is the second straight game UNCG has gotten off to a really quick start. They jumped on Samford right around that 9-10 minute mark in the first half to push it out to a sizable advantage, and they've done the same here so far against Western Carolina.
Western Carolina is not going to stay in kind of the shooting slump all game long, so Spartans better get what they can get while they can.
Langley curls again the opposite side, misses it again, and Allegri tried to save it. Spartans come up empty. On this end, though, it has been a struggle for Western Carolina. One of their last 11 from the floor, and a wild shot there by McCray is no good.
Western can't get any friendly rolls at all.
Dickey back door to Langley, flips it in, and he's fouled.
Nice touch. Just a little change of pace. Langley set that up so effectively. Let's see if we can get that on the replay to see what he did to get so wide open. See here on the cut. Watch him kind of, you can't see it from that angle. But watch him just change his pace. Great lead pass from Dickey. And a great touch, kind of putting the reverse spin on the ball.
Flips it up and in as Faulkner whistled for his first personal foul. And Keyshawn Langley, 96% from the free throw line on the year.
You know, one thing that's, you'd be surprised, but one of the biggest transitions that guards, especially little quick guards, have to make coming from high school to college is playing at different speeds. Oftentimes they go 100 miles an hour all the time. It's not till the next year that they have to slow down. Keyshawn has such a great feel for when to change his pace, uses hesitation. It's really, really sharp for a freshman.
Faulkner draws three Spartan jerseys around him, and whistle will come in on James Dickey. That's the eighth team foul, and for James Dickey, that will be his second, and Mo Abdul-Salam will come to sub in for him as Faulkner makes his way to the free throw line and doesn't get the roll. Came into the game 116 of 150 from the line. So he does it outside and certainly makes his way to the stripe, but has struggled here today. Legri had a notion, steps back mid-range, high arcing shot, no good. Faulkner weaving through traffic. Beautiful pass to Dotson, and foul on Langley, who just got caught in the air.
Great play that time. Nice hesitation, crossover. Keyshawn just had nothing for that one. He just couldn't quite get around, tried to body him up, sees it, couldn't help himself. Knew he needed to stay down, but instinct just was there.
Yeah, just a great pass by Faulkner. So Western at the line, they are 3 of 6. Still, the Catamounts with only 4 made field goals here in the first half. If it wasn't for these last couple trips to the free throw line, it would really be a lot more painful for the purple and black to look at.
Isaiah got himself a nice rest on the bench. It's been a while since he's been back in the game.
Turns the corner left side. Here comes the double team. Skips it out to Galloway. Now to Hewitt. Hewitt all the way back to the line. His three rims around. No good. And Isaiah Miller there to clean it up.
In the right place at the right time. He was down there already. Might as well make something happen while he's there.
Isaiah now with 6 points. 33-14, Dotson carefully with it, kicks it out to Steger, gives it right back to the big fella, and he converts underneath.
That's a mismatch, sharp decision from Western Carolina to go right at him.
Abdul Salam wants a touch.
Get him an outlet.
Gonna back his way in, get to that right side, and just didn't have the angle. Catamounts will run off the Spartan miss. Faulkner, keep an eye on him.
Senior versus a freshman right there.
Dotson just backs his way down, pulls his way down. Couldn't make it that time.
Moe is probably the lone player in the gold jersey that can bang a little bit with Dotson.
Miller pulls up quickly and off the mark. That offense for the Spartans, which was moving the ball around to start the game, has slowed down here now. Western try to make a little run, and Faulkner, no whistle, and then one does come in late, and it's going to go on Galloway on a hold. So now 10 team fouls on the Spartans as Galloway is whistled, and for Kyren, that is his first. And here's Dotson, who is 3 of 4 from the line.
Well, the Spartans, as you said, have to get back offensively. They're moving the ball around some. Pass, drive, inside, out, go back inside. When they did that, they got any shot they wanted.
Dotson in double figures with 11 now. 11 of the 18 coming from the big man. First meeting at 15 points and 10 rebounds. 33-18, Spartan lead has been as high as 20. Western hanging around, Miller nearly turned it over, and then Faulkner with the reach in, and that will be his second. And immediate timeout here in the Greensboro Coliseum. Western Carolina hanging around, making trips to the free throw line. Spartans still leading big, though.
Wasn't me, baby. No, it wasn't me, baby. Mm-mm, baby, wasn't me. Must have been some other body. Uh-uh, baby, wasn't me.
Free 2-hour grocery delivery, now with Prime.
This is the Chevy Silverado with the world's first invisible trailer.
Invisible trailer?
Hop in. Silverado offers an optional technology package with up to 15 different views, including one enhanced view that makes your trailer appear invisible.
Wow, that's pretty sweet.
That's cool.
Where's the trailer though?
Get 0% financing for 72 months on all 2020 Silverado 1500 pickups. Plus, eligible GM card members get $1,000 in bonus earnings. That's on top of most other offers. Find new roads at your local Chevy dealer.
Honey, you feel so soft and sweet.
Charmin Ultra Soft.
It's softer than ever. Charmin Ultra Soft is twice as absorbent, so you can use less. And it's softer than ever, so it's harder to resist.
Okay, this is getting a little weird.
We all go. Why not enjoy the go with Charmin?
UNCG out in front with 3:58 to go. And if you're just joining us, Spartans led by as many as 20 on two separate occasions. And really, it's been the Catamounts just hanging around, taking advantage of the whistles going against the Spartans and making free throws.
7-10 from the free throw line. Dodson, like you said, has 11, 5-6 from the line. That's what's giving them some life, because offensively they just can't find any rhythm whatsoever.
Catamounts just 5 of 23 and 1 of 6 from 3. Club that makes 10 threes a game, just 1 of 6. But to your point, you know those are going to come. Those are going to come. And Spartans just going to get back into that rhythm they've had on this side as Galloway with a rare post up underneath.
That. Do something simple. Now, the Spartans have to be sure that they end this half the way they started it. Don't want to let Western cut this thing down to single digits. That's going to give them the momentum.
McCray directing traffic. Got caught in the air, but Dotson there to intercept it, flings it over to Harris now. Shot clock at 4. Harris will drive in, scoops one up, didn't go, and underneath, Abdul Salam outduels everyone for the rebound.
Great job of perimeter defense that time on Harris.
Miller down the lane with the left hand, wouldn't roll in. But he'll head to the line.
Yeah, he just pushed the head before the black jersey started turning around. Got right to the rim, you can see here. Running past everybody, two or three jerseys could have been there to stop him. And it's going to his left, which is something that teams are really scouting him to go to his right. So action that he needs to start getting stronger and more confident with.
...53% on the year. Isaiah, sometimes he looks really good from the free throw line, like that one. Shot that with confidence.
He just has to not think about it. Just step in and fire it.
Knocks them both in.
There you go. Ready, Mo.
Under 3 left to play first half. Faulkner back on the floor. They go way over the top deep. And Dotson again just going to determine to get in the paint. Threw that one away. Galloway diving for it, but last touch by the Spartans. 13 on the shot clock.
You know, even though the press, you know, didn't get the turnover, you could see that Western could never get settled. UNCG continued to jump passing lanes and to be aggressive on the ball, and there was two or three opportunities for a turnover there.
Halverson is inbounding it, and Western almost turned it over. Faulkner going to drive it all the way in, threw it away.
Great job by Mo going vertical and just kind of going back with the offensive player with Faulkner. Faulkner caused all that contact.
Miller turns, fires from 3. Wouldn't go down. Dotson away with another rebound. It's his 6th of the half.
Yeah, I like that shot, though, because he just made a couple of free throws, feeling good on the stroke.
And then another foul on the drive as Galloway picks up the whistle. Oh, they give it to Isaiah Miller. Or let's see. They will give it to Isaiah, so that's his first. And here's McCray at the line, and it'll be 2 free throws. And Western 7 of 10 from the line. McCray rolls it in and saw that graphic came up on the screen. Faulkner with just 2 points. He's 0 of 6 from the floor. And, you know, Matt Halverson, who averages almost 11 a game, second in the conference in three-pointers made at 65, and he's yet to even attempt a shot. Lead is 17 as Miller brings it across.
I can see Caleb get something good through the basket here on the drive just to get himself going.
Double comes on Abdul Salam. Yep. He'll dive after it, but shoved off in the process.
Yeah, no communication. They're seeing the double. No outlets that time. Good defense from Western Carolina. And it's another 65-70-foot trip to the free throw line.
And Abdul Salam has picked up his second. James Dickey on the bench with two personal fouls. Malik Massey on the bench with two personal fouls. And here's Ano Steger, 75% free throw shooter, to shoot two. And the free throws, you know, you're down 17, and it's hard to say free throws have kept you in it, but free throws have kept this game from being a 25-28 point lead for UNCG. The opportunities at the line for the Catamounts and their ability to knock them in.
And for someone like Steger, maybe he just needs to see that go through the hoop. Maybe he gets one in here into the first half, and then he's off to the races in the second half.
Miller with Halverson on him, likes that matchup, is going to back him down in the post, sweeps through the lane, and
post him up, back him down. That's going to be some better help side defense or a double team from Western on that play. You can kind of tell what Isaiah wants to do.
Faulkner off the screen, gets rid of Miller, and now he'll put his head down, runs over Miller, and that'll be a charge on Faulkner.
Isaiah recovering. You know, they set that ball screen to get the mismatch to get Allegre on Faulkner. Western does that a lot. They use ball screens to get mismatches. Spartans scouted that out. Isaiah saw it the whole way. Jumps straight up and down, takes the contact.
Miller going to turn the corner on Halverson, and wow. Oh, okay. Here did come the foul.
Okay.
Yeah. So, and Isaiah will go to the line.
Yeah, Isaiah going strong that time. Gets the mismatch. You kind of see right there, it's just sort of a, look, I'm going to put him at the free throw line. Going to earn it type call.
It was a delayed whistle from the outside where the pause was.
Yeah.
And Isaiah rolls in another free throw.
Yeah, I was about to say, this isn't the NFL. That's definitely a foul.
You find your way to get your shots in, don't you?
Yeah.
Swishes them both. 4-4 from the line for Isaiah Miller, and double figures to lead the way for UNCG now with 12 points. One minute left here in the half. McCray down the lane. Can't finish over Galloway. They'll battle for it. Offensive rebound back to Steger. His three is no good. Dotson with another board. He's going to keep it here. Spins. Goes up with the left hand. And a foul on Galloway, who's in a little bit of disbelief.
It's Dotson is just such a load in there. It's hard to know how to handle it. You get aggressive. He's banging people around, and you try to bang back. That's why he's so effective inside in the Southern Conference. Agile, knows how to use his body, knows how to score off angles. Tough guard.
He's already attempted 6 free throws. This will be number 7 and number 8. Mark Prosser pacing the sidelines. Take a seat here.
We'll see if the Spartans go 2-for-1 here.
Bring Michael Hewitt in for Kobe Langley. Miller down to the baseline, back to Hewitt. He'll fire the three off the mark right side. Ball batted around underneath, body's hitting the floor. And it will be Western basketball. Well, they did try to get a quick hitter anyway for Hewitt. He's unable to knock it in. He'll check out. They'll bring in Kobe Langley. 28.7 left.
Let's try to play a possession without fouling. A triple team. I don't think that's what the Spartans wanted.
Avoided the double team, and there's a basket.
There was a miscommunication.
Marcus Thomas.
Yeah, miscommunication of what was supposed to happen there.
And Isaiah Miller with the ball in his hands. 6 seconds left, gets the high screen. Swings it to Hunter. He'll drive in, some contact. They'll let him play on. Now, wait, a whistle comes out late. And there will be a offensive foul on Caleb Hunter. I think the official made the call. Now he's going over to the scores table. Maybe it's to see if there was any time left. Let's look again here as Hunter drives in.
Yeah, it looks like the position was there.
I guess it was the running into Dotson. Scott Przewanski, Daryl Koziak back inside the Greensboro Coliseum with you. UNCG out in front 41-25. Spartans have led by as many as 20 on two different occasions. You look at the halftime statistics, and you know, we talked a little bit about it. Could be a lot worse for Western Carolina if it not for their ability to get to the free throw line and convert.
Yeah, that's sort of the flip side to the aggressive defense that UNCG plays. They get into traps sometimes where they put teams to free throw lines, especially walking 70 feet, 90 feet down the floor to shoot them, so they're not able to make their defense work. On the flip side, Western Carolina has 8 turnovers, so that's a trade-off that the Spartans sometimes have to make.
Mason Faulkner on the floor for Western Carolina, leading scorer for this club at 18 a game, and he's got 3 personal fouls, has struggled here today, and immediately we start the second half with another whistle against the Spartans, and it will go against Kyren Galloway. That'll be his second. He's got 2. Dickey has 2. Massey has 2. Hunter has 2. Langley has 2. Abdul Salam has 2 for UNCG.
So they might want to play the lotto with twos tonight. 2, 22, 12.
Back inside to Dotson, who has shown to be the consistent offense for Western Carolina and spins to the goal for an easy basket. Think about this for Western. Steger, Halverson, and Faulkner all average in double figures. They are a combined 2 of 14 from the field in the first half. Halverson didn't even attempt a shot. He's the second leading three-point maker in the conference at 65. So the Spartans have done the job defensively on everyone except Dotson. Dickey flips one up, never really had a handle on it. And can the Catamounts get back-to-back baskets? I'm not sure that they did that at all in the first half. Faulkner finds one he likes, 3 is short. And the rebound run down, Steger almost had it, and then flips it over somehow to Dotson underneath.
Western Carolina coming out with a few plays they want to execute, doing that well, climbing their way back into this game. You knew their offense wasn't going to stay that flat the whole game.
Dickey backs his way in the pace, and it will be a foul on Western Carolina. It looks like it's going to be on Faulkner on a reach-in. And if it is, that is his 4th.
Let's see, we'll take a look here. I think the bump right there.
There's the reach in. You saw the arm come in, and that's what they got Faulkner on. And Dickey's free throw is off the mark.
4 fouls, wow.
So Faulkner.
You got to know when you got 3 fouls, you can't get that foul. You can't. That's a real blow to Western Carolina's offense.
Hasn't been able to get anything going here tonight. You see his frustration.
Could hear the Western Carolina bench next to us calling for a travel. It wasn't a travel.
Western over the top of the press. Steger ball fakes the 3, drives it in, back to Halverson. McCray, freshman who came in for Faulkner. Again, they are just going to run everything through Dotson. Misses that one.
Yeah,
had another great look.
A lot of success. I'd run it through him too. When you got that kind of size, offensive weapons, gets deep post position. It's an advantage you have on the floor. You got to keep feeding them.
Dickey into the paint over Steger. Couldn't get it to roll in. McCray drives in. No help side defense that time. And again, it's Dotson underneath. And Western has cut this lead down to just 11. A lot of standing around on this UNCG offense, isolating. Miller floats one up. Airball that one. Here come the Catamounts. Chance to cut the lead down to single digits on this trip. Dotson surveying. No double team coming. He's just going to wheel his way in and just backs his way under on Dickey, who was able to get the block. And Dotson steps out of bound. That time, one of the few times, Dickey's length ends up being a factor.
He's just trying to stay between him and the basket. Moved his feet that time. There's a lot of banging on both sides. Spartans may have to start double-teaming him. They may be satisfied to go one-on-one, but Dotson might foul out the entire front court.
Miller backdoor to Hunter, went right by him, and Spartans have not been crisp, to say the least, here to start this second half.
They're wobbling a lot of passes, so the timing of these plays are off, and Caleb has another attempt or another action around the basket that he just can't get a good look on.
And a 10-second violation. McCray just a little too patient. His teammates frustrated yelling at him, and the Spartan bench celebrating on the other end. So two possessions in a row for Mark Prosser's club where they could have cut the lead down to single digits.
And McCray, a freshman, having a hard time dealing with this pressure and it's being decisive because the Spartans are changing it up. But that deep pass down to the corners is open. They just got to throw it. Standing around, like you said, that's exactly what Western wants.
Miller lines up a three, that's no good, and last touch by Galloway and out of bounds. Massey will sub out. Keyshawn Langley comes in for the Spartans.
They need to get more action to the basket. Langley's the guy to provide it.
So Western Carolina with a couple baskets from Carlos Dotson here to start the second half. And this is their third chance to cut the lead down to single digits. And the Mounts just to get it across the timeline again. Steger with it. And looking for Dotson. Poked away by Dickey. Stay on this end of the floor. And a media timeout. Sluggish.
Where they battle. These are their homes. This is where they become Rhodes Scholars and academic All-Americans. This is where titles are forever. This is the Southern Conference.
Never has it been a better time to join the Spartan family. For as little as $100, you can join the Spartan Club and power the success of our student athletes. Visit SpartanClub.org today. The Spartan Club, supporting student athlete success since 1986.
Good night. Good night.
Hey. I was watching that.
You've seen it like 10 times.
You've seen it 10 times?
I drive the carpool in the morning.
Yeah, we both have to get up early.
Just turn it back on.
Okay.
Sometimes you just have to move. Penske Truck Rental. Free and limited miles on one-way rentals to keep you moving forward.
Western Carolina starting off the second half with a little 6-1 run, and they're doing it basically without Mason Faulkner, who has just 2 points, is on the bench with four personal fouls. You know, the Spartans did a really good job against him up in Culloway when Faulkner only went for 5 points, he had 6 assists, 5 turnovers, and he struggled here again tonight against the Spartans. Yet his club, trailed by, 15, 20 points most of the first half, finds themselves down by just 11 and with the ball with a whole lot of basketball left to be played.
A lot, and Steger and Halverson, two of the better three-point shooters in the conference, really haven't got going yet. So Dotson's carrying them. If either one of those two gets going, then they're going to be right back in this thing.
Dotson, 18 points and 9 rebounds. He'll slip him to the goal. Steger holds. Abdul Salam guarding Dotson now. Steger's going to drive in. Dropped it off to Dotson. Foul on the Spartans, and to the line goes Dotson. They just have not been able to prevent the big fella from catching the basketball underneath.
He's such a wide load. It's going to start early. Going to keep him out of the paint. You can kind of see they started well, but good action from Western Carolina. Ball screen, drive, a little kick. Weak side couldn't get over to Dotson in time.
That foul on James Dickey, and that is Dickey's third. And Dotson now 6 of 9 from the line. James Dickey will sub out. They'll bring in Angelo Allegri.
That's going to put a lot of pressure on Abdul Salam to kind of go a little bit. He's got 2 fouls, but he's really the only one on the Spartan squad that can bang with him even a little bit.
And a 10-point game. Abdul Salam back to Miller. Miller going to back his way in on the freshman, sweeps through the lane, left it short. Abdul Salam on the blocks, and he's fouled. And to the line, he will go.
Yeah, Isaiah's getting action too there, but he's doing a lot of falling away, kind of this flip shot, instead of going strong. So he's short on everything to pass 4 or 5. You can see a nice little jump hook there, but he misses it. Mo reads it well off the rim, just the first one to the ball.
That was on Steger. That's his first, as Abdul Salam, 36% on the year for the sophomore. And this second half, Western Carolina has just seeming to, I'm trying to figure out how to describe it, just suck the life out of the energy here in the Coliseum, just with steady pounding play. And well, lead is at 11.
It is them, but I also think just the Spartan offense is just really gotten out of sorts and not really nearly as crisp as it was in the first half. They're not looking to play together. They're not generating their own momentum.
Langley going to try to do it himself.
Like, short like that.
That one. Miller underneath finishes off the rebound.
Again, Isaiah just in the right place, but that's not the shot we need in that situation.
45-32. Cray will drive in, kicks it to the corner to Halverson. Back out front. Thomas drives, missed it. Abdul Salam with the rebound. UNCG, can they score off of their defense? Allegri finds a three, rattled it in.
Transition, they want to shoot those good looks in transition. I think it's a good look because it went in. If it didn't, I wouldn't be so kind.
Pushes the lead to 16.
They just need to feed big fella Dotson every single time.
Well, the mismatch, he's got Hunter on him.
Oh, foul. Yep.
And there is a foul on Caleb Hunter.
Yeah, you can kind of see they're kind of waiting on that one. Caleb was there. You see that arm bar. Luckily he wasn't called on that one, but just continued presence. That arm bar, that trying to block the movement. You know, officials have an emphasis for freedom of movement, especially in a mismatch like that out in front. Referee's going to blow that whistle.
That was Caleb Hunter's third personal foul. So Hunter has 3. James Dickey with 3. Abdul Salam bodying up here with Dotson. Kept him out of the paint a little bit and caused the air ball and then a reach in.
Well, what Mo did is he did just enough to put a little bit of distance between Dotson and the rim. Just get him out of the lane. Just get him just enough, which you got to play defense against him before he catches it, because after he catches it, forget it. He's got you in his back pocket and it's over.
Langley burst down the lane but lost it. Steger picks it up. Catamounts now will run. McCray inside to Dotson. Again, great position and fouled one more time. He's just got a low center of gravity, and he's quick enough with those first couple steps. He gets that position. Back to the line he goes. Dotson 7 of 10 from the line. Now with 20 points to go along with 9 rebounds. And Mark Prosser's going to roll the dice a little bit and bring in Mason Faulkner with his 4 personal fouls. Wes Miller on the other end looking for any kind of solution to big number 0 at the line.
Coach Prosser felt the Spartans kind of pushed it back to 16. Didn't want to wait for that lead to get to above 20 again, because that would have been over.
Langley, nice kick out to Allegri. This three spins out. Abdul Salam and Dotson are wrapped up on the center of the floor, and Dotson will be whistled for the foul. That'll be his second.
They're banging inside that time. Good look from Allegri. But I like the move from Coach Prosser to get Faulkner back in the game at this moment.
Carlos Dotson didn't like the call. Hewitt from three and swished it in.
Yeah, knocked to the ground, got to get back.
He does not
Quick
need to warm up
trigger.
Any, does he?
Quick trigger three. Trigger.
Elks right back into Dotson. They'll just let him go for another bucket.
Yeah, and that's where Mo, and he's getting a lesson. I mean, because you know what? 2 years from now, that's going to be Abdul Salam to the Southern Conference. He does take this game tape and learn what Dotson is doing before he catches the ball. That's what he should be doing when he gets a little stronger.
Back to Hewitt. He'll fire another three.
Oh, he check.
Rebound pulled down by Tyler Harris. 51-35, UNCG leading.
So Abdul Salam needs to have a body on Dotson right now.
And let's see, last touch by Western Carolina and out of bounds. 12:28 on the clock. James Dickey will return. His 3 personal fouls. Abdul Salam a bit winded. He'll check out. It's a nice greeting from his coaching staff.
Yeah, I don't think we're going to see more than one big man on the floor for the Spartans the rest of the game, just to spread out the fouls. It's going to be 4 guard lineups the rest of the way. It has to be.
Isaiah Miller, Malik Massey, Michael Hewitt, Angelo Allegri, James Dickey on offense here for UNCG. Miller rifles it over to Massey. Quick touch pass to Hewitt. He'll drive. Flips it to Dickey. Gathers himself. Goes up.
Good move. Nice action. See, look at that action. Cutters, flare screens, curls to the basket.
Lead goes out to 18. Western had cut the lead to 10. Faulkner with some breathing space. Can't get it to drop in. Just has not been able to get into a rhythm this evening. Miller, head of steam down the lane. Scoops it in.
They want to push the offense. One of the things that UNCG thought is they continue to push it on offense, they could wear down Western Carolina starting at about this point in the game.
Spartans have made 5 of their last 7. Western 1 of their last 8 now.
Keep going. Attack the glass, then kick it out.
Miller forces one up, feeling it a little bit now. He's got 18, 57-35, and a block on Hewitt near the timeline. Well, when the Spartans get going, they really get going. Western cut that lead down to 10, and then number 1 said, you know what?
This is Desert Creek Honey, an artisan honeymaker on Amazon. This is the owner, Blake, with his 8 million coworkers.
They never complain, they never give up, and that really inspires me when I try to run a small business.
This is how they get their honey. This is Blake, walking like a boss because he is a boss of his own business. More than half of everything sold on Amazon comes from small and medium-sized businesses like Desert Creek Honey, and you can find them on Amazon.
If you need lumber wood, Lonnie's is better than good. We also have the best selection of plywood in the state. Hey! Dang woodchucks, stop chucking that wood!
Geico Sequels. The savings keep on going.
I'm offensive assistant coach for the San Francisco 49ers. I'm not just here to be the token female. I'm here to help us win. The Surface Pro helps me get what's in my head and get it out onto the field.
Let's go. Let's run it again. Run it again.
This is the Chevy Silverado with the world's first invisible trailer.
Invisible trailer?
Hop in. Silverado offers an optional technology package with up to 15 different views, including one enhanced view that makes your trailer appear invisible.
Wow. That's pretty
sweet.
That's
cool. Yeah.
Where's the trailer though?
Get 0% financing for 72 months on all 2020 Silverado 1500 pickups. Plus, eligible GM card members get $1,000 in bonus earnings. That's on top of most other offers. Find new roads at your local Chevy dealer.
UNCG on a 6-0 run over the last minute or so to push the lead out to 22. Want to remind you, as always, the road to March Madness once again rolls through Asheville. We hope to see you there March 5th through 9th. You can see all the action from both the men's and women's tournament live and on demand on ESPN Plus and the Watch ESPN app. For all the info on tickets, brackets, hotels, and more, visit SoConHoops.com. That's not CozyAcHoops.com, but SoConHoops.com. And here today, Western Carolina just relying on the big fella, Carlos Dotson. He's got 22 of their 35. Western Carolina has made only 10 field goals. He's made 7, and the defense by James Dickey.
Dickey took a gamble on that one, a smart one. A weak pass trying to get on the inbound.
Again, think about that. Western Carolina with just 10 made field goals, and 7 of them have been by that big fella right there, Carlos Dotson, who's been great, 22 points and 9 rebounds. 59-35 UNCG. Dotson trying to do everything. Shot clock all the way down to 8 now. Western Carolina drive in, and there's an easy hoop by Marcus Thomas.
They were all afraid of the dump-off pass, didn't want to pick up another foul.
Miller whips it inside to Dickey. Can't go up and under on Dotson and then draws a foul on a reach-in. And that will go on Marcus Thomas. And the fifth team foul against Western Carolina, and that'll send James Dickey to the line.
And next time Dickey gets it on the block like that against Dotson, I'd like to see him square up, face up, because he can beat him quick-wise. He's not going to be able to back him down unless he can get an angle and kind of speeds around. If he faces up, throw a little shot fake. If he doesn't go for it, shoot it. The next time, shot fake, go right past him. I think facing up against Dotson, Dotson's the way to attack.
...61-37 UNCG as we approach the midway point here in the second half. Dotson goes right back to Steger. He'll drive baseline. And a foul as Massey got caught in the air. A little bit shaken up on the court as well as the senior. That's the third of the game on Massey. Little shaken up in the midsection. And Steger to the line. Ando Steger, 6'5 senior from Ohio, 75% shooter. This Western Carolina team shoots 69%. And right about there at 70, 14 of 20. They knock in their 15th. Steger had such a good game in their last outing with 24 in the loss to Furman. Like everyone except number 0 has struggled to score the ball. Massey weaving through traffic. Faulkner really pressing up on him, aggressive with those 4 personal fouls, but 10 minutes to go, you're trailing 61-38. Got to get something going if you're Western. Miller going to drive in, finishes one more time. There's just no one there to prevent him at the rim.
Yeah, everyone on the weak side taking advantage of the mismatch with Thomas. Thomas not quite there yet to guard Isaiah.
Dickey goes high for the rebound, just kind of taps it to himself. Isaiah Miller with 20 on 8 of 15 shooting, 6 rebounds as well. Isaiah wants to go one-on-one, kicks it out to Massey. Massey's 3, strong, and Dotson away with the rebound. He's got a double-double now, his 10th board coming. Harris will back it out. Spartans playing strong on the ball, man-to-man defense. Dotson can't turn the corner, but somehow flips it in.
Left-handed. Doing all kinds of things tonight, keeping this team, fighting for his team.
24 now for Carlos Dotson. Matson drives, or Massey drives in, and Faulkner just kind of turned around and looked at the official. I think he thought it was a push-off.
Hand check, you get around attacking. Western Carolina's help side defense has really been non-existent the past few possessions.
Steger, and there's a 3. Just the second made 3 of the game for Western Carolina. Their team, which makes 10 on the season, but just their second make. And it comes here with 8.5 to go in the game.
Couldn't get a good pass there as a set for Hewitt.
Shot clock winding down for Malik Massey, back out to Galloway. Spartans have to recognize the clock. Hewitt will let it ride. Never bashful to take the shot.
Yeah, better pass from Galloway to Hewitt. Might have delivered a better shot.
Thomas spins. Nice ball fake. Puts it in. So a couple nice moves by Marcus Thomas. Off the bench. Lead stands at 20. Miller weaving, spinning, floating. Couldn't finish it. Dotson underneath clears it away. Slips to the basket. Deflected though by Miller. Quick hands. Hewitt ahead of the pack. Rifles it to Galloway. Flushes
nice
it home.
Break. Great control break that time. Galloway run the middle. Hewitt, wait, perfectly timed pass. Nice great shot fake. Don't rush it. That's how you do it.
Harris had it stripped away by Miller. Miller then had it poked back away by Harris, or did he? No.
No, I think Isaiah just was trying to figure out how he was going to attack the rim that time. Lost track of the ball.
Spartans pulling away, 67-45. Galloway finishing off the feed, and UNCG rolling here at home.
First sight brick, for sure. I love to give recommendations, see somebody else use my brick just based on a picture or seeing my house like that. To me, it's exciting.
GEICO makes it easy to get help when I need it. With licensed agents available 24/7, it's not just easy. It's having Jerome Bettis on your flag football team easy. Go get him, bus!
Ooh. Come on, bus, come on!
Hey, wait! Man, I got the flag! I got your flag!
It's GEICO easy. Yeah. With licensed agents available 24/7.
49-0!
More than 500 physicians and providers, 30 medical specialties, 100 locations, all with a single goal, to help you feel your best. Cone Health Medical Group works collaboratively to ensure students, faculty, and families get access to the right care with the right provider, in the right place, at the right time. With offices close to where you live or work, you'll find a partner focused on helping you prevent illness and improve your overall health and well-being. For more information on exceptional care in your neighborhood, visit chmg.com.
Carlos Dotson, the big man for Western Carolina, has been outstanding. 8 of 17 from the floor, 24 points and 12 rebounds. And it starts with his position, doesn't it?
Yeah, he gets inside early, takes advantage of mismatches. Coach Prosser and the staff does a good job of putting him in those positions, but he's really had an all-around game. You just saw that last clip. He was about to put the ball on the floor from 15 feet and make a play, so just look at him.
Yeah, 8 of 17, 8 made field goals, the rest of the team just 6. And, you know, at the free throw line, he's 8 of 12, but he himself has drawn 9 fouls on Spartan defenders himself.
And the problem, though, is I think that the tank is almost on. It's not quite on E. Maybe it's on a quarter, but it's getting there.
Faulkner down the lane, still cannot get it to go. Ball carried off Faulkner, who was on the deck, and somehow Western still ends up with it. Harris going one-on-one and gets the roll.
Yeah, Western hasn't had too many of those rolls tonight. First one I think they've gotten.
Hunter from the elbow, jump shot. Okay. He banked it in, kind of shakes his head a little bit, but he'll take it.
Nothing easy tonight for Caleb.
Scored 4 early in the game and then has struggled. Happy to see that one go through, no question about it. And the Spartan double team back to Dotson. He'll go down the lane. Just kind of eases up, flips it to Steger, misses the 3. Hunter away with it, now to Langley. Galloway straight on, high arcing 3, missed it badly. 69-47, Spartans with 5.5 to go. Faulkner, who's basically played the whole second half with 4 personal fouls, is going to give way to Dotson, who does a little sweep through to get James Dickey wrapped up in him. That's the 4th of the game on James Dickey. So he'll take a seat as Abdul Salam comes in, and back to the line goes Dotson. Yeah, as Dickey takes a seat.
Again, the best defense on Dotson is the defense before he catches the ball. Once he catches it, he's got you under his will.
This is the front end of the 1-1, though. Langley calls his own number and knocks it in.
All right, young fella. I tell you what, you shoot that shot, it better go in.
Dotson just doing it himself, muscles it in for another bucket. Back door to Hunter, not a whole lot of space there, and UNCG a rare turnover, just their 7th here of the game. Steger, ball fakes, he'll drive it in. Allegri hits the deck. Steger can't finish it. Offensive stick back is there for Myers. And a timeout by Wes Miller here with 4:32 to go. The lead is still at 21. Just wants to regroup everybody here a little bit.
With TD Ameritrade, you've got courses, tools, and help from pros.
It's almost like you're training me to become an even smarter, stronger investor.
Exactly.
Come on, another trade. I want to see it. More.
'80s style training montage?
Yeah.
Happens all the time.
Into the end zone, it's a touchdown. Pepperidge is under right. Bang! He could go all the way.
Tom does a good job getting the ball out there, making a play for a touchdown. That's why he studied film.
Georgia, Georgia, the whole day through.
Showtime.
It's all about
about number seven. It's all about Vic.
Vic turned himself in today.
I wanted to know the truth.
I took advantage of the moment. We all did.
Other games taking place around the Southern Conference today. East Tennessee State in control. Looks like they'll get a W. Mercer and Wofford in a close one. Chattanooga by 20. And Furman continuing to roll forward as well. Spartans will be at Mercer this weekend. Vasilidis swings it over to Hunter as you look at the conference standings. And still a lot yet to be decided in conference play.
Everything's real tight. You know, only real advantage amongst that is the, you know, the East Tennessee State tiebreaker over UNCG with two wins. So Spartans have to get some help to climb over the hump to get up to number one.
That foul was on Faulkner and his fifth. So he will sub out. And been a tough game for the conference's second leading scorer as he struggled to get in a rhythm with some early missed shots and early foul trouble. And I think UNCG's defense focusing on him as well, and the number of different guards they can put on him, certainly made for a tough road here tonight as he finishes up with just 2 points.
Not how we dreamed about this game. He certainly wanted to get back against the Spartans because he struggled last game, but never could get going. Struggled early with the pressure. Got some fouls called against him, and this kind of went south from there.
Rare miss at the line for Langley. Misses them both, and you can tell he's frustrated with himself. He came into the game 28 of 29 from the line, and he's still got his hands behind his head, frustrated that he just missed two. Coach Miller is going to call over his freshman guard. It's okay. There'll be more.
Free throws. Heck.
Maybe he's telling him that, see, I told you I was a better free throw shooter than you. Meanwhile, Dotson has been 8 of 13 and knocks in another. Now with 27. Another good game by the Catamount big man against UNCG.
Left shoulder! Left shoulder!
Dul Salam backs his way in on Dotson. And here is a foul on the Catamount big man.
Fire TV Cube? Alexa, turn on the TV. Play Master Chef. Alexa, volume up.
Done.
With TD Ameritrade, you've got courses, tools, and help from pros.
It's almost like you're training me to become an even smarter, stronger investor.
Exactly.
Come on, another trade. I want to see it.
80s style training montage?
Yeah.
Happens all the time.
The internet can be wild sometimes. I get terrible stuff on social media, in my DMs.
But the good news is that we can do something about it.
Right now, a movement of young people are stepping up to shred hate and choose kindness.
Help us flag and report hate accounts on Instagram and elsewhere.
Sign up to Shred Hate, Choose Kindness with DoSomething.org, ESPN, MLB, and No Bully.
Text SHRED to 38383.
DoSomething.org. Let's do this.
Spartans with two players in double figures. Isaiah Miller with 20, James Dickey with 11. They play a lot of guys, and they're successful when they do play a lot of guys, and they all contribute. This was another example of that here tonight, Daryl.
Yeah, it's one of the advantages they have, I think, over everybody else in the conference. You look at the bench points tonight. Spartans with a huge advantage, 27-10. You got, you got Allegre with 6. You got Langley with 9. You got Hewitt with 9. You got Abdul Salam with 3. So they're getting contributions up and down the roster, and it's exactly how Coach Miller has developed this team.
And 1-1 now for Mo Abdul Salam. Allegri will run down the loose ball rebound. His pass deflected though and picked up by Douglas Elks. And they'll hold up play here with a little issue with the shot clock and game clock. Western Carolina next up. They'll play at Wofford. Look at their schedule, and VMI, the Citadel, and Samford at home before closing out the regular season in Johnson City against East Tennessee State.
Yeah, that's an important little three-game homestand there for Western. They really could generate some momentum going to East Tennessee State. If they get those three at home, which they could do, they're going to be up for it against East in Johnson City. Well, that's a rivalry by itself, just the close proximity to each other.
Western Carolina, one of the teams, you know, fighting for that top four, you know, in the mix for that top four in the conference, which, you know, receives the bye in the Southern Conference tournament. They rattle off those three at home. They've got not out of it yet. McCray swings it back out, long three-pointer away, off the mark there. And last touched by UNCG and out of bounds. And Western Carolina has not been able to get many good looks from beyond the arc. And 2-15 here inside the Greensboro Coliseum. Spartans. Biggest lead tonight, 25. Dotson muscles it in for another basket.
Yep. Mo did everything right there except try to reach to steal that pass. If he just, on the pass, settled in behind Dotson, Dotson wouldn't have had an angle to put the ball on the floor and go right to the rim. It's a teaching point. Because Mo did a great job pushing him off the lane. He just went for a steal he shouldn't have.
Dotson now with 30. That's adding to a new career high. Probably looking for some more here if he gets another touch. Three by McCray is off the mark. Fosilita with the box out. Steger can't finish underneath. They'll run for it. And here's Langley out of the pack. Down the lane, Keyshawn Langley all the way in.
Good split on the 2-on-2 fast break. I figured who was on the wing. I think it was Caleb. Went wide, allowed Langley with just enough of an angle to carve through the two remaining defenders.
Langley nearly ripped it away. And another easy bucket for Dotson underneath. He might want to move to Greensboro after this game. 32 now on 11 of 20 shooting and 10 of 15 from the free throw line. And don't forget the 12 boards as well.
I think he might be the leading candidate for player of the week. What do you think?
I think so. Boslida, the freshman for three. But the Spartans have almost been, you know, it seems like content to let him do what he's going to do. And focus on everyone else on the team. And Dotson has taken advantage of it, but for Western Carolina fans, the other four on the floor have not. Steger, one of those who hasn't been able to get anything going here today. The Catamounts will have some token pressure here now in the backcourt. DJ Myers, a sophomore from Raleigh. For Western Carolina, out on Langley. Another three ball, and Langley is giving some space.
Deep.
Knocks in the three, and Wes Miller calls a timeout so he can get Keyshawn Langley out and bring his twin brother, Kobe Langley, onto the floor. 81-59, the Spartans completing this three-game homestand. They got three wins, but did they get out of it what they wanted, being able to practice here maybe a little bit more? And you know, you're going to end up with three wins at home, all with probably 20 points or more.
Yeah, they certainly were got out of whatever funk they were in, continued their dominance at home, I think sent a message across the conference, continued to develop the bench, continued to develop their press. You'd like to see them foul less, but that's just the nature of how they play.
Hunter down the lane, tried to dunk it on Dotson, and it'll be a foul. Let's see, who does it go against? It's going to go on Travion McCray.
Let's see if Caleb, just frustrated with the night he's had, just hasn't been able to kind of string any momentum together, although he's had opportunities. He's just to flush this game off, move on to the next one.
Can't get the free throw to drop, and Spartans will go to their bench as Ryan Tankiewicz, walk-on waiting to come in. Kyrie Thompson just entered. Caleb gets 1-2. Here comes crowd favorite Ryan Tankiewicz, whose brother is a member of the Spartan coaching staff and played at Western Carolina. Tom. He's a good shooter, too. 81-62. Tankiewicz with the block. The crowd
block.
Loves it.
He's got one more than his brother ever had.
he can
take that with him. Family dinners.
Spartans can hold it without shooting if they want. And Western now going to back off. And UNCG will let this one roll out. As UNCG led the entire way here tonight. Again, led by as many as 25, led by 16 at the half. Western Carolina came back, cut the lead down to 10 in the second half. And then the Spartans went on another run and pushed the lead out to 20. But Carlos Dotson, outstanding for the Catamounts, a career-high 32 points.